Hey guys, Tony here, and welcome back to another episode of TT Bird Game Reviews. Today's episode, we're going to be looking at a PlayStation 4 game. And yes, like I promised, I would be looking at more PS3 and PS4 games on this channel, and I'm going to keep my promise to the fans and subscribers here. And the game I'm going to be looking at is a game that was only released in Japan and Asia and stuff, but had a multi-language version that has English subtitles and stuff. So, the game we're going to be looking at today is Dead or Alive Extreme 3 Fortune on the PlayStation 4, also known as Dead or Alive Extreme 3 Venus on the PlayStation Vita. And like I said, this game was only released in Japan, so the only way you'd be able to buy it is if you go on PlayAsia.com or Amazon and stuff. And be sure you get the multi-language version so you can read everything and stuff and understand what's going on with the subtitles. So. But now, to start things off here, I first got into the Dead or Alive series and playing Dead or Alive 3 on the Xbox at my friend's house back in the year 2002. I knew it was a fighting game and stuff like that, and me being a big fan of fighting games, I convinced my buddy and I to play the game and stuff because I was a big fan of fighting games at the time. Of course, still am a big fan of fighting games like Tekken and Soul Blade and stuff like that, and I wanted to try this one out because I heard it was different, and lo and behold, it was. Now, I know the Dead or Alive series has been known for, like, having like, hot girls in the game and stuff like that, but that's not the reason why I enjoyed the game. I enjoyed the game because it was a good fighting game and stuff like that. And I happen to own 3 Dead or Alive games total right now. Dead or Alive, Dead or Alive 2 Hardcore, and Dead or Alive 5 Last Round. But, of course, there was the Volleyball series, which I will be talking about, which was kind of a spin-off to the series. But now, let's get out of the way, let's start things off with talking about the story. And the story starts off with Zack, one of the characters from the Dead or Alive game, talking to you about how he built his island, how it was destroyed twice in the first 2 Dead or Alive Extreme games. But he didn't give up his dream, and he rebuilt New Zack Island again for the 3rd time. But this time, however, he's putting you in charge of New Zack Island as the owner, because he's busy with a very important job on a different island, so it's up to you to run the island stuff and such, and that's pretty much what the story is all about. It's very simple, and it basically gets the job done. It's just a story that moves the game along, and that's basically all I say about the story. Now, when you start here, you have 9 female characters to choose from. Now, I know a lot of people complain that not all the female characters from the Dead or Alive games were in here, but 9 is a good number of characters. I mean, I know they couldn't fit all them in because, like, there was actually a voting contest going on what girls should have been in there. Now, while I admit, like, characters like Tina, Rachel, and Christy were characters I would have liked to see in there, but we still have a good amount of characters here. Like, we have Kasumi, Momiji, Hitomi, Helena, Marie Rose, Hanaka, Nayutengu, and Kokoro and stuff. But for this review, I'm going to be playing as Helena Douglas, because she's the character I've been playing as the most here, and she's one of my favorite characters. Now, I usually would play as Hitomi, but in this game, I like playing as Helena more for some reason. Now, when we start the game, we are treated with a cutscene here that pretty much explains why the character's there and how and what they're doing there. And basically, Helena is trying to find out what Zack is up to this time on New Zack Island and stuff like that, and trying to figure out what's going on. But she decides to take a break and just relax and stuff and just have fun. And that's pretty much what she does. And then after that, we have a random girl be our partner. For this playthrough, we see that Momiji became our partner here. But I'm going to switch partners and have Hitomi be my partner, because usually when I play as Helena or Hitomi, I usually switch on and off between them. So if I play as Hitomi, I have Helena be my partner, but in this case, I play as Helena, I'll have Hitomi be my partner and stuff, and that's basically what we do from there. And as we get started here, you'll notice that the game's graphics, for the most part, are really good. For the most part. The backgrounds are great and very colorful and very detailed, and the best part about the backgrounds is the water, and like the water looks amazing. Like, it's one of the best looking water you'll ever see in a video game. And the framing for the most part is really smooth. There's a very, very few times where the frame rate will hitch up and stuff, but for the most part it's really smooth. You probably won't even notice it and stuff. But the worst part about the graphics is some of the character models look really unfinished. Like, character models like Kasumi and Nayutengu, there's like, if you look at their faces don't look very detailed as like other characters' faces do. Like Kasumi and Nayutengu's faces look like they were from a last gen video game and stuff like that. and suggest they could have been better, but for me, the best looking character models are of course Helena and Hitomi in my opinion. And now, let's talk about the sound. The sound is also really good, but there are a couple complaints I have with it. To start off with, the voice acting is fantastic. It's all the original Japanese voice acting. It doesn't have the English track option like how it was in previous Dead or Alive games like Dead or Alive 5 and Dead or Alive Extreme 2, because the English voice acting was terrible, and I'm glad they just stick with the Japanese voice acting, because that's the way to go. But I do have some complaints here about the sound, though. First off, the music is really repetitive. Like, there's only like about 8 tracks or so, and they just loop constantly and they get annoying right away. And I couldn't find an option to turn the music off, so that's gonna be kind of annoying if you don't want to hear the music and stuff. You just want to just like, forget about it, but you can't. And also, there's no custom soundtrack. I know that the custom soundtrack thing was mainly in the Xbox and 360 and stuff like that, but the PS3 and PS4 give you the option to transfer songs from a USB flash drive or an external hard drive onto the system, and it would have been nice if they would have had the option to put songs you put in and stuff, but unfortunately that's not the case though, because it would have been nice because that music is just really annoying. But some of the songs have lyrics in them, and they are some of the better tracks, but they loop over and over, and they just aren't really worth it in the end, listening to, I mean. The background atmospheric sounds are also realistic. You hear like crickets chirping, wind blowing, sand like people walking on sand and stuff, and the water splashing sounds good. So the background atmosphere sounds are realistic and sound great. It's just a shame about the repetitive music and stuff, because it really hurts the sound, but it doesn't hurt the sound badly. But now let's talk about the gameplay. And before I get started here, this game has gone through so many updates since this game was first released almost 2 years ago and stuff. And like, when I first got the game, this game really needed some updates. Like, there were some control problems and stuff like that and such, and just some noticeable bugs that some clipping problems here and there and stuff like that. But the clipping and like a lot of the bugs have been fixed up. Like, the controls are actually a lot better. And those of you who played other extreme beach volleyball games, like the Dead or Alive Extreme games, you'll feel right at home with the controls. And if you want to hear more about the controls, I'm just going to watch a tutorial video, because this is a review. I'm not going to waste time talking about the controls. But for the gameplay here, we do have a bunch of mini-game modes here, a bunch of modes here to play as, or games to play. First, we have beach volleyball, which is obvious, doesn't need any explanation, just like you and your partner and two computers, and you must get up to 7 points to win or something like that, and that's basically what it is. But we also have some new modes here, which I didn't play Dead or Alive Extreme 2 that much, so I really don't remember all the games it had in there, so bear with me. Next up, we have beach flag, which you and your partner must race to the end to get the flag. We have butt battle, which you and your partner are on a platform. You must try to knock each other off into the water. You have tug of war, which is obvious, needs no explanation. Rock climbing, which is basically quick time, which basically you climb a cliff, a rocky cliff or whatever, and you must hit the buttons at the right time to get to the top and get to the fastest time. And you have obviously relaxed mode, where you can just watch your character relax and stuff. Pool hopping mode, which has pretty much been there for like ever since the first game, and you can pretty much play by yourself or play against your partner or any computer character. And that's pretty much all the modes there are there. I know in Dead or Alive Extreme 2 there was the water slide mode and the jet ski mode, which have been taken out, which is kind of a disappointment, but then again, the main part was the volleyball mode, so I'm okay with it. But there's also a new mode here, which is pretty much kind of like a second game here, called Owner Mode. Owner Mode is basically a Sims-like game where you're the owner and you must try and impress the girls by giving them gifts and stuff like that, buy them things, and watch them relax, take photos of them, watch them play volleyball and stuff like that. It's basically one of those type of things, but I didn't really spend much time with the owner mode. I found owner mode to not be as fun as the girl mode, because the girl mode, you actually get to play the games instead of watching like I do in owner mode. One new thing they added here is the satisfaction rate. And this is what it means, that your satisfaction rate for your character ranges on 4 hearts. And if you can get your satisfaction rate up to like 4 hearts or so, you will get the best ending for each character, which is pretty much the enjoy the night option that you have after 14 days go by, which I have to mention that each girl is on the island for about 14 days, so 2 weeks or whatever you call it. And you basically have to try and impress them by like giving them gifts, winning beach volleyball, winning rock climbing, and like to get the most satisfaction points, you must win beach volleyball and or rock climbing or so. Or buying or being the owner and buying the character you selected a gift that they really enjoy and stuff like that, and you'll get their satisfaction rate up and they'll start trusting you more and you'll get the best ending. It's a nice feature to have and I enjoy it. The way you know your satisfaction is maxed up is when the character's picture, profile picture, or whatever you call it, like their picture will have a pink circle around it when you're fully maxed out. You'll have a pink circle, a half red circle, and stuff like that. But if you screw up and give them a gift they don't like, your satisfaction rate goes down, 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 down. And then we have the casino mode, which has been in this series since the first game, but unfortunately the casino has been kind of disappointing here, because In the other two games, you had slot machines and stuff like that, and those have been taken out. All you have now is roulette, poker, and blackjack, and basically, like, they're fun to play and stuff like that, but unless you do missions for that, because I forgot to mention, you have missions that if you have girl mode missions, and owner mode missions, and the girl mode missions, like, the only time I ever really went to the casino is to do, like, the girl mode missions and stuff, where they want to play blackjack, like, 10 times or so. That's pretty much all I did. But I have one major complaint about the gameplay here, and this is something that I know a lot of people can agree with me on, is the microtransactions and loot boxes that are in the game. What I mean by that is that like, you have swimsuits in the owner shop that are available for a limited time, which is okay, I don't mind that part. But the problem is that like, you have to buy and download catalogs from the Japanese, Chinese, or Chinese version, or the Hong Kong version of the PSN store, using a Japanese or using a Japanese PSN account, and you'll have to waste money buying catalogs for swimsuits that don't even need to be like that and stuff. I mean, it's not as bad as it was with like a Battlefront 2 2017 was and such, or other games in the past that like Need for Speed Payback and such, but still, it's just kind of annoying, but thankfully there are a lot of swimsuits that don't require that, so that's not a big deal for me at all. But now let's get into my rating of the game, and my rating goes like this. Dead or Alive Extreme 3 Fortune is a good game, but it has some problems with it. Like I mentioned before, the repetitive music, no custom soundtracks, the fact that some of the character models look unfinished, and the fact that the casino has been stripped down and such, and the fact that the microtransactions and the loot boxes here affect the game, but do they hurt the game badly? No, not at all. It's still a good game. I bet it's still a great game, just not a fantastic game, like a perfect game, like a perfect 10 out of 10. But if you can get past all these flaws here, I give the game an 8 out of 10. It's the perfect score and stuff, and I hope you all can check this game out when you can. You can buy it from Amazon or PlayStation.com, like I said, and that's pretty much all I gotta say. This is Tony, aka TTBird88, peace and out.